The 2023 annual crime report that was released on 21st of February this year indicates that 528,025 traffic offences were reported in 2023, reporting an increase of 15.5% from 456,993 cases in 2022. The same report indicates that a total of 23,608 road crashes and 4,179 of them were fatal. While digesting the report, the head of Traffic Police and Road Safety, Senior Commissioner of Police Lawrence Niwabine, noted that pedestrians and border riders are mostly at risk while on the road. He blamed this on the poor road designs, with no specific pedestrian walkways.
72% of all the pedestrians who died were knocked while crossing the road or walking along the road. This is an important fact that should be picked by policymakers and see how to improve the road design to cater for pedestrian walkways.
Going by the age group, the report indicates that persons below the age of 35 who are youth and are productive accounted for 60% of death on Ugandan roads, while in terms of gender, 74% of the death were for males, while females accounted for only 26%. The Albertine region leads with 374 deaths, followed by Kampala Metropolitan North at 373, Kampala Metropolitan East at 333 deaths, and Kampala Metropolitan South with 331 deaths, and the Ruzi region with 322 deaths.
The population of this country is a young population, and we need to save it. For those who are old, maybe you are a bit spared, you are very careful, but the age below 35, really, they are dying.
Also important to note is that the Uganda police collected over 35.8 billion shillings paid by traffic offenders in express tickets. The same report indicated a 1.4% increase in sex-related offenses, with a total number of 14,846 cases reported from 14,693 cases in 2022. Particularly, cases of defilement and aggravated defilement had increased by 1.5% and 6.2% respectively. Majority of these cases happened in the eastern region due to a number of factors.
There are so many children who do not go to school and they are married off early. We have so many child mothers. So, you know, when you give birth while a child, chances are very high that you may not manage to raise another child.
Explained issues of social and cultural practices, issues of economic practices, school dropouts. So you find that children are not in school and therefore they engage in sexual activity early.
A total of 1,144 fire incidents were reported, indicating a 9% reduction as compared to 2022. School fires also reduced by 23.1% from 65 cases in 2022 to 50 cases in 2023. The Directorate of Fire and Rescue Services registered a decline in fire incidents. AIGP Joseph Mugisa attributed this success to the number of factors.
Increased massive fire safety campaigns, targeted in nature, and our main focus was schools, called them education institutions, markets, especially those that are not yet developed, and garages, timber yards, just to mention a few.
Meanwhile, the police are hunting for their own. The officer in charge of a Leptong police station, Achayo Moses, who killed the suspect. It is said that Achayo opened fire against a suspect behind the murder of his brother.
We also recovered the gun yesterday, an AK-47, that's being submitted today to the ballistic expert for them to conduct an urgent trace of the killer gun. We want them to help identify when, where, and to whom this gun could have been allocated.
The Uganda Prison Service has broken its silence about the ongoing plans to relocate Luzira Maximum Prison and replace it with a 5-star hotel. Commenting about the matter, prison spokesperson Frank Baine said the matter is currently in ministerial level where discussions are still ongoing.
As far as we are concerned, this is a transaction or a conversation going on between the president, the Minister of Internal Affairs, and the Attorney General. For now, Uganda Prison Service is not part of this.
In a July 2022 letter to the Minister of Internal Affairs, President Museveni gave a green light to the idea of giving land currently housing Luzira prisons to a Chinese investor of Tiantang Group to construct a five-star hotel and relocate the maximum security prison to another area. Report by Rachel Nachwala for the news.